They have been labeled the heroes of the unrest, outmanned police diverting rioters away from the Senate chambers. But in towns across the country, police leaders are taking a hard look at who is among the troublemakers.
If they became involved in criminal activity, which would have been engaging with the Capitol Police and trespassing into the Capitol, then they probably aren't going to be law enforcement officers much longer.
In Seattle, the chief has placed two officers on leave, saying the department fully supports all lawful expressions of the First Amendment, but the violent mob and events that unfolded at the Capitol were against the law, and if any of its officers were involved, pledging to terminate them. The NYPD says it'll help the FBI to ID any active or retired personnel who may have set foot on Capitol grounds. And closer to home, sources say a Philadelphia detective posted pictures of herself in D.C. around the time of the unrest. It's unclear when the photos were taken, and the source says the pictures don't show her taking part in the Capitol riots. But the Philadelphia Police Department has reassigned the detective while it investigates.
She went out on her day off, from all accounts, minding her own business, and it's exploded, and you know, she's caught in the middle of it now. So once this is done, she'll be back to work and be back as a detective and doing her work in background.
Departments in the region say there's no ban preventing officers from taking part in rallies or political events, but certain rules have to be followed.
It's one thing going to an event, it's another thing going to an event, being disruptive and breaking the law. That's where the problem lies. If you go to some event and then you become an issue, or you're breaking other rules or regulations of your department, or you're breaking the law, then it's a problem.
Fred Herron oversees Bensalem police, fire, and emergency medical workers for the township and says all can exercise their First Amendment rights, but each case can warrant a different evaluation, including social media use.
We look at social media during background investigations, and we continue to look at social media.
Now, police chiefs we talked to say there is a big difference between going into a closed building or posting anti-government sentiments. Those things, they say, can get you to lose your job. However, breaking the law can also earn a criminal prosecution as well. In Fort Washington, Deanna Durante, NBC 10 News.